But first this morning, it's already being called the defining moment of Barack Obama's presidency. His decision to go ahead with a daring raid to take out America's most wanted man. Even his harshest critics have offered nothing but praise after the death of Osama bin Laden. Attention is now once again focusing on Ground Zero in New York, and the president is due to visit tomorrow.
When Navy SEALs raided this Pakistani compound, they found Osama bin Laden and his family on the second and third floors. The White House says the terrorist leader resisted but was unarmed.
Bin Laden was then shot and killed. He was not armed.
Behind the 18-foot-high wall, the aftermath of the raid is chaotic. Dishes, carpets, and clothing lie scattered on the floor of one of the buildings. Outside, onlookers hold what appear to be pieces of the U.S. helicopter that stalled during the raid. Officials say DNA and facial recognition technology were used to identify bin Laden, but now Taliban leaders are questioning whether or not he is actually dead. They say the U.S. hasn't provided concrete proof. The White House says they do have photos of bin Laden's body and his burial at sea, but they're still debating whether or not to release them.
It's fair to say that it's a gruesome photograph. It could be inflammatory.
Some in Congress think releasing the photos would put conspiracy theories to rest.
I think for purposes of 100% identification, there's value in doing so.
U.S. lawmakers are asking how the terrorist leader could live in an affluent Pakistan suburb undetected for years.
We need to understand exactly what it is the Pakistanis knew and didn't know as far as the situation that unfolded this weekend and then the years leading up to that.
But Pakistan's president denies his security forces sheltered bin Laden. The Pakistani government was not told about Sunday's raid, and the Obama administration says it is looking at whether bin Laden had a support system there. Danielle Nottingham, 10 News.